Joining me on the panel is Dr. M.J. Khan, president of IMPAR. Also joining us on the show is Major Mohammad Ali Shah, media panelist, IMPAR. Sumit Peer, political commentator, also joins us on the chat. And last but by no means the least, PKD Nambiar, political analyst, is also here with us. Gentlemen, thank you so much for being a part of this very crucial and rather an intellectual debate. Mohammad Ali Shah, you want to say something? Go ahead. Mohammad Ali Shah, go ahead. You want to say something? Go ahead.
Govind, thank you very much. You know, I heard the points, all the three honorable panelists of Dr. M.J. Khan, who I respect very much, Mr. Nambiar, Sumit Peer, and all of them made a lot of sense. And I am totally on the same page with Dr. Khan. I think he made a lot of sense and he put across his points in a very balanced way. See, I'm a Muslim. And I believe only if I respect the religious sentiments of the other community will the other community respect the religious sentiments of my community. It's as simple as that. Now, both you and I, we have been into the modeling industry earlier. Now, I have done several ads which have not been released on television, which ultimately had to be released on OTT, on YouTube, because they didn't pass the QR to be released on television. So any ad to be passed on ultimately to get conceptualized, and after being shot, you have to go through a proper process. And if it has been selected, it means it has been got the approvals. Now, when an ad like this has been approved, we have to keep in mind that everybody is very, very touchy about their own religious beliefs. Everyone. And they are entitled to it. Fine. Now, it is not the responsibility of the ad agencies to teach everyone or to give tips about how to conduct themselves in a communal harmony, in how to live together as a society. No. Secondly, what are the ad agencies actually interested in? Commerce, making money. You know, a controversy always sells. Though the companies always feel like, okay, let's invest a bit in an ad, let there be a controversy, and then we can backtrack on it, and
that
then
it can go itself. Now, that doesn't work now.
Let him finish. PK.
It doesn't work now.
Sumit, let him finish. Let him finish.
I'm on the same page. Sumit, that's what I'm saying. Let me finish. So it doesn't work anymore because a company like Fab India, a big brand, now I have seen on Twitter, people are saying, oh, I ripped off my Fab India kurta and now I'm cleaning my shoes with it. So a publicity, as Sumit said, it doesn't work anymore. It works adverse. They have to understand that now. It's very important. Now, when an ad like this, irrespective whether we are intolerant or not, the intention of any company, of any brand, is ultimately commerce. It is not about promoting religious harmony. Whether it does or it does not, that's irrelevant. But they want to make money at the end of the day. So we have to be very, very careful about touching upon religious sentiments of any community. That's what I would like to say.
All right. Mohammad Ali Shah, the question also stands that, is there only tolerance from one side of this equation and there is none from the other?
Avreet, Karl Marx once said religion is the opium of the masses. And obviously we all know that we all are very, very touchy about our own respective religion, our own personal beliefs. And it's our faith is a very personal matter. And best it's being personal, being kept on our own private issue. Fine. Now, as Mr. Nambiar said, people who are trying to communalize it. Now I would like to ask everyone, who has made this advertisement? Vineet, you and I have been into modeling. We know that an ad to be released, it takes a lot of selections to ultimately see the light of day. Now, who has made these ads? Is it the Muslim community? Is it the Hindu community? Or is it a particular community who has tried to communalize it or promote religious harmony or whatever the intention would be and then made it? We cannot really say. It's a company, right? Now, when we have Hindus and Muslims sitting and debating about it, and a Muslim saying, no, I don't see anything wrong in this ad, it's only promoting religious harmony, and a Hindu saying, no, Hindus, when feelings were hurt. You know, when I was fasting in the month of Ramzan, if somebody would not understand that I've kept a roza, I have no problem in telling them, aaj mera vart hai, aaj main khana nahi khaunga. I have no problem in that. But the community at large, would everybody feel this way? Would everybody else communicate this way? So ultimately, the intention of any company who is playing up on the religious sentiments and trying to create a controversy, you think, see, I would say mera worth hai to my domestic health, perhaps, because my domestic health will not understand what a roza is. But I would not put on social media that Ramzan Mubarak, worth Mubarak. I would not put that, or I would not make an ad. So obviously a sensible person knows a controversy would be ultimately raked out when these procedures are set and these boards are set to see the, to make sure that the ad sees the light of day. The person, this intelligent person, knows that there would be a controversy.
Thank you so much for being a part of this wonderful conversation.